In today's video, we will discuss the periodic table and about how the modern periodic table came into being. The periodic table is a tabular array of the chemical elements organized by atomic number from the element with the lowest atomic number to the element with the highest atomic number. The aim of the classification of elements is to group together those elements which resemble each other in some respect, and to separate those elements which differ. The best classification will clearly be that which brings together elements which resemble one another in the greatest number of ways. We will talk about the scientist who helped in making the periodic table, such as Dobereiner with his triads, Newland's octaves law, their Myers classification, Mendeleev's periodic law and periodic table, and finally, the modern periodic law. In 1829, Johann Wolfgang Dobereiner, a German chemist, discovered that within a group of elements of three which resemble in chemically, the atomic mass of the middle element is approximately the arithmetic mean of other two elements. This is known as Dobereiner's law of triads, such as, the atomic mass of lithium is 7 and mass of potassium is 39. If we take arithmetic mean, then the answer will be 23, which is the atomic mass of sodium. The next attempt was made by an English chemist, Newland. Between 1864 to 1869, he arranged the elements in the ascending order of their atomic weights. He observed that properties of every eighth element is similar to the properties of the first one. He called this regularity law of octaves. As you can see, lithium and sodium are both alkali metals, and sodium is the eighth element after lithium. There are some advantages and disadvantages of law of octaves. For advantages, it provided a basis for the arrangement of elements which are similar in properties into a group. For disadvantages, this periodic arrangement didn't include noble gases, that is helium, argon, neon, etc., as they were not discovered then. Next is Lather-Meyer's classification. In 1869, German chemist Lather-Meyer classified 56 elements arranged in from groups 1 to 8. Meyer plotted values of certain physical properties such as atomic volumes against atomic weights and obtained some curves. From those curves, he observed that elements with similar physical properties occupied similar positions, such as alkali metals lithium, sodium, potassium, etc. were at top, while halogens fluorine, chlorine, bromine, etc. were at the ascending part. Disadvantage or drawback of Meyer's classification were that Meyer's periodic table was incomplete compared with Mendeleev's periodic table, which was published in the same year with remarkable predictions. In the year 1869, Mendeleev, mainly on the basis of physical and chemical properties, discovered empirically a law known as periodic law, which he stated as, the properties of the elements are a periodic function of their atomic weights. Mendeleev arranged all 63 elements known at that time in order of increasing atomic weights. He arranged them in 7 horizontal lines, called periods, and in 8 vertical columns called groups. Merits of Mendeleev's periodic table were systematic study of elements. He made predictions of certain elements which were found to be amazingly accurate when the elements were later discovered. Mendeleev corrected the atomic weights of some elements, such as atomic weight of beryllium 13.5 was corrected to 9.4. There were also some demerits, such as position of hydrogen is not clear. Isotopes weren't assigned separate places. Mendeleev himself disregarded his periodic law in certain places. For example, tellurium 127.6 was placed before iodine 126.9. Dissimilar elements such as coinage metals, copper, silver, gold were placed along with alkali metals. In 1913, Moseley, a British physicist, established that atomic number is the fundamental property of the elements. On this ground, he stated that the properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. So how did the modern periodic law remove defects of Mendeleev's system? Well, it did have many weaknesses, but its main weakness was due to consideration of periodic law based on atomic weights, which was corrected by considering atomic numbers. Just like that, by basing the classification on atomic numbers, isotopes also got separate places. The anomalous placement of elements also disappeared automatically, and rare earth elements or lanthanides and actinides got place in periodic table. Here, I have attached the modern periodic table. You can apply all of the statements we studied in the start to see that all of those helped us in achieving this periodic table we see as of today and use for our ease. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked the video. Be sure to give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe.